and the 2009 Thanksgiving Day Fest held at Hyatt Hotel in Bethesda, Maryland, by the Vegetarian Society of BC. It's probably the best food they've ever had. They've had some excellent food.
Yes.
Thank Nancy for introducing me to this wonderful lifestyle.
Yes, and tell us about how vegetarianism is kinder to the animals, Kitley Whitley.
Kinder to the animals because you don't have to raise them for slaughter. It's kinder for the environment because you don't raise so many animals for factory farming, then you don't have tons and tons of animal poop and waste to get rid of, which goes into our water supply and gives
listeria. It is a major source of pollution.
And it takes you 1/50th the resources to grow a pound of soybean as compared to a pound of beef.
That's true. And factory farming also uses up a lot of petroleum, too.
Well, it certainly does.
It puts a lot of strain in the soil and ecosystem.
Yes, it does. And certainly, if anyone's ever seen the factory farming conditions and how they are for the animals.
Oh, they're awful.
Yeah.
Stack chickens in battery cages, six or more deep, and the top ones poop and tingle down, and the others. Human beings wouldn't want a condominium where everyone was in a cage floor and they tinkled poop to the people below. I don't think they'd like that.
No, they sure wouldn't. They'd be extremely unhappy.
Right.
And so, unfortunately, these factory farms don't even think about the animals as being living beings with needs and feelings of their own. They just think of them as a means to make a profit and feed a lot of people for a burgeoning population.
They're not concerned with the feelings or the comfort or the well-being of the animals. They're simply objects for profit.
That's right. And so that's why we encourage more people to try a vegetarian diet, and you'll find it's a lot healthier for you, too.
You will lose weight and you have less cholesterol.
Definitely. Thank you, Kit.